In this video, I explain you essential component of diesel power plant, or this theory also called as the layout of diesel power plants, by using the animation, so you will understand it easily, and how to draw these diagrams by different systems that I explain, so you can easily understand and you not need to revise this theory again. So first we go through the basic systems and then go to the animation. The diesel power plant consists of the following component. First one is the engine, then after second is the fuel supply system, third one is intake system, fourth one is exhaust system. We also compare these all the systems with our human body, so you can easily understand it. Fifth is the cooling system, sixth is the lubrication system, seven is the starting and stopping system, and eight is governing system, nine is generator. Component is the engine. So engine is the main component, okay, so this is the main component of diesel power plants. The function of engine is to develop mechanical power for a generators. Okay, so in a diesel engine, we supplied the diesel and it is converted in mechanical energy. So as in our human body, we take the food, okay, so it's contain chemical energy and it is converted in work energy as well as in a heat energy. So similarly, in a diesel engine, we supply the fuel, that is diesel, it have the chemical energy, and first it is converted in heat energy by combustion, and then after this heat energy is converted into the work energy. So this diesel engine is our human body. Okay, in diesel engine there is a number of systems, like we inhale the air, that is known as the intake systems. We remove the some gases from the our body, that is exhaust system. Similarly, the fuel supply system is there, so we can understand later on. First we understand what is the engine. So diesel engine used for diesel power plants may be 4-stroke or 2-stroke engine, that you already know. 2-stroke engine is compact in construction and simple in mechanical designs, cheaper in cost, smaller flywheel require and develop the more power for a same speed compared to the 4-stroke engine and piston displacement. However, 4-stroke engine has lower specific fuel consumption, more effective lubrication, more flexibility, less noise, exhaust, simple and better cooling, better scavenging and higher efficiency than the 2-stroke engine. So we use the 4-stroke engine in a diesel power plant compared to the 2-stroke engine because it have a number of advantages. Generally, 2-stroke engines are favored only for diesel electric power plant, mainly due to high power outputs, uniform turning moments, compactness and the less capital cost. So these are the favor points for a 2-stroke engine. Nowadays, high diesel price and high diesel price means the high operating cost of the 2-stroke engine is favored to use 4-stroke diesel engine for a diesel electric power plant. The diesel engines are available in a size from 75 kilowatt to 40 megawatt. The size and number of engines depends on the plant capacity, purpose for which plant is being set up and the load characteristic. Means how amount of capacity plant is used, it depends upon the requirement of the customer. Second is the fuel supply system. Before moving ahead, I request to like the video and subscribe the channels for watching the more video related to mechanical engineering, and also visit the playlist for studying the various subjects of mechanical engineering. Now second system is the fuel supply system. Okay, so this is the main diesel tank. From this main diesel tank, the diesel is first supplied to the strainer, then after it is supplied to the transfer pump, and this transfer pump supplied the diesel into a daily consumption tank. Okay, and if the daily consumption tank is overflow, then this diesel is again supplied it to the main diesel tank. Now from this daily consumption tank, first here fuel filter is put it. So fuel filter is remove some impurities and dust particles from the diesels. Then after this diesels is supplied to the fuel injector. So this is the fuel injectors, because the diesel are injected into a diesel engine. So fuel system, so in our body, what is the fuel? We eat the food, okay, it's chemical energy. So diesel have a chemical energy. In what we eat, that is a food, it's converted into a different energy, heat energy, then energy supplied to this our body. Similarly, this diesel supplied to the diesel engine is converted in heat energy, and this heat energy is converted into the mechanical energy by using the cylinder pistons connecting rod and the crank. And our stomach is absorbed the food, and this food energy is converted into different nutrients and then supplied to the different parts of the body. Okay, so this is a main diesel tank, same like as the our storage room of the foods, where we store the foods and take the necessary foods for the daily purpose. Okay, so here main food is stored, that is the diesel tank is stored, and daily supply is here. Okay, so according to daily requirement we supplied the diesel to here by using this different pump. So in a fuel system, it consists of the fuel storage tank. So this is the main storage tank, then this daily consumption tank, fuel transfer pump, strainer, fuel filters, and the fuel injection pump. So these are the main six components: diesel tank, strainer, transfer pump, daily consumption tank, fuel filters, and this is the injection system. The fuel oil may be supplied at a plant site by truck, railroad, and a tank and car. Means how the diesel is supplied to this diesel tank? So it is coming from the truck, either railroad or a tank or a by the car. The functions of the fuel supply systems are to transfer a fuel from storage tank to daily consumption tank. Means first the diesel is supplied from this storage tank to daily consumption tank. This is the one function. Second function is to filter. Why filter is required? To remove the different particles from the diesels. Third one is to increase the pressure of fuels. So pressure of the fuel is increased in the transfer pumps. Here also one injection pump is provided. And to measure and control the fuel supply, means how amount of the diesel is used, that is measured by the flow meter device that is not shown in this image. And to inject and atomize, means for inject and atomize, here the fuel injection is used, injector is used. Atomize means spray in a form of small particles the fuel in a engine cylinders. Next system is the intake system. Okay, so intake system means our human body is also take the air. Okay, so what the we eat the food, that is our the fuel supply system. Now we also inhale the air. Without the inhale of the air or oxygen, we are not able to sustain our life. Okay, so similarly for a combustion purpose in a diesel engines, we need to supply the air. Okay, so for that air filter is provided. That is generally our noses work as air filters in our human body, that removes some dust and that in our nose, and then after it is supplied to our lungs. Okay, so similarly this is the air filter that remove the dust particles from the air, then after this air is supplied to diesel engines for a combustion, and this is known as the intake system. It consists of the air supply pipe. So this is known as the air supply pipe. Okay, this is the air filters, and supercharger in case of the supercharged engine is used. The functions of air intake systems are to clean the air. So air is clean in these air filters, then to supply the air from supercharging in a case of supercharged engines, and to reduce the noise of a air intake systems. If you want to watch the various video related superchargers, then link is provided on top right screen of your laptop or mobile from the I symbols. Link is also provided in the descriptions. Second is the exhaust system. So our human body take the oxygen and remove the carbon dioxide. Similarly, whatever the input is supplied, it is converted into a some outputs. Okay, so here we see that the fuel and air is supplied in a cylinders, it combustion is takes place, and after the combustion some work is utilized from these gases, and remaining gases is exhaust to the atmosphere. So one exhaust system is required. So exhaust gas is supplied in this exhaust pipe, then one silencer is put it, and the exhaust gas go to the atmosphere. Okay, so it consists of the piping from engine to a point where exhaust gases may be discharged without danger of annoyance. A silencer is usually incorporated in this system to reduce the noise level. So silencer is generally used to reduce the noise levels, and in a some silencer the different system is put it to reduce the emissions of the system. Next is the cold water to the jacket, that means it is the cooling system. Okay, now in a summer seasons, okay, in any seasons, okay, our human body is also related to heat energy. Okay, in a winter seasons we feel the cold, in a summer seasons we feel the heat. Okay, so at that time in a summer seasons we require to AC, in a colder seasons we require to wear the jackets, means this jacket and another extra sweaters are increased our body temperatures. So our body have certain comfort temperature is required. Similarly, the engine is also required to cooling systems. Okay, why it's required a cooling system? Because in a cylinder that temperature is too high, near to the 2000 to 2500 degree centigrade temperatures. So they are increase the temperatures of another components, and if we not cool the another component, then the damage of the components are possible. Okay, so we need to remove the heat from this component. That's why the cooling water is required. So cold water is supplied to the jacket. Okay, so first cold water is supplied to the engine. So this cold water absorb the heat energy from the different components. Then this hot water from the jacket is first supply one surge tank. Okay, in a surge tank the hot water is collected, then after this hot water is supplied by using this water pump to the one heat exchangers. Okay, so this is the one heat exchangers. In a heat exchangers that is a one pipe is there, from this pipe hot water is supplied and another cold water is used, that is supplied to outside of this pipe. Okay, this cold water, this hot water is converted into cold water, then after it is supplied to the oil coolers where this water is used to cool the air. Okay, that we understand during the lubrication system. Now so here you see this cold water is connected with this pipe. Okay, now to cool this hot water we are required another water. Okay, so we take the water from the cooling towers. So this is a water circulation pump. This cold water is supplied in this heat exchanger. So this cold water is absorbed the heat from this hot water. So this hot water is converted into cold water and this cold water is converted into hot water. Now again we require to cool this hot water. Then this hot water is supplied it to the cooling tower. Here the water is sprayed and this water particle is come into contact with the air. So this due to help of, with the help of the air, this water temperature is reduced and the air is out from this upper part of the cooling tower and cold water is collected in this bottom part of the cooling tower. And this cold water is supplied to the water circulation pump and this heat exchangers. So this way the cooling system is run continuously. Now we understand why the cooling system is required. The function of cooling system is to provide proper amount of water circulation all around the engines to remove the part of heat from the engine cylinders and keeping the low temperatures at predefined levels. So in short it is used to remove the heat from the cylinder and maintain the temperature of the engine. Cooling system is consist of the water jacket. The water jacket is provided surrounding to the cylinders, then the jacket water pump, then the surge tank, cooling tower, raw water pump and the these heat exchangers. Now next system is the lubrication system. Now in our body we know that is a various joint is there, knee joint and in a hand number of joint is there, and sometime the when the age is increased the joint pain problem is start, that is a knee joint pain. Okay, and this problem are starting due to the lower level of the oils in these various joints. Okay, so similar way when the some parts have the relative motions, our leg have a relative motions when we walk. Okay, at that time the lubrication is required and the lubrication is not there, at that time the wears and tear is starts. Okay, so where the any component have a relative motions, at that place we require to the lubrication system. And in our body get the lubrications from the food we already eat. Okay, but in engines we need to separately supply to the oil to the various component. Okay, for that we supply oil to the engines and this engine oil is supplied to the various system, that is known as the lubrication system. That is a various type of system is available, and if you want to understand the various type of the lubrication system then go to the iSymbols where the link is provided for a cooling and lubrication chapter. And also in description the link is provided. Okay, now this oil is returned again because its temperature is increased, it take the some impurities and due to the wear of various components. So this return oil is first connected in a oil tank, then after from the oil tank the diesel is supplied to this lubrication oil is supplied to the oil pump, then after the oil is filtered in a filter, then after its temperature is reduced in a oil coolers. Okay, so how this temperature of the oil is reduced? So temperature of the oil is reduced by the cold water supply to the system. Okay. Then after the oil temperature is reduced, then it's supplied to the our system. So that's where the lubrication system is continuously run. So here you see that is a various point of lubrication system. It consists of lubricating oil tank. So here you see this is the tank, this is the oil pump, next is the filters and lubricating oil cooler. So this is the lubricating oil cooler. The function of lubricating system is to provide a proper amount of oil to minimize the frictions and wear of the rubbing parts. The oil cooler is installed in order to keep the temperatures of lubricating oil low in order to sustain the property of lubricating oils. During this lubrication purpose, they absorb the heat from various parts, and if the oil temperature is continuously increased, then they lose the property, they lose that viscosity, they lose the viscosity index. That's why we need to cooling of this oil to maintain its property. Then after, next is the starting system. Okay, in our human body, we naturally start the, our heart is naturally started when we take the bone. Okay. But in engines, we need to start the engine by using the some system. In our bike, in our car, we start the engines by accelerators. Okay. So when we give the, when we start the bike with the kick, then what the happens? Okay, that is a different mechanism is there. When we rotate the key of our car, so in a car there is generally electric motor is used to start. So in a diesel engine, that is a various matter. By using the electric motor, we can also able to start the diesel engines. But in a large size of the diesel engines, one air compressor is used. So air compressor is increase the pressure of the air, and this air is stored in a one tank, and this tank is supply air to the engine for the starting. And when the engine is start, this starting system is closed. So next system is our starting system and the stopping system. The starting system is used to rotate the engine initially while the starting until the firing is start, and ultimately run its own power. Means starting system is run only when the firing is start. When the firing of the diesel is start, combustion is start, so it start to produce the power. Then after this, working of the starting system are closed. Small diesel engine plants are usually started manually by handle. By handle means it is work as a kick in our bike, okay. But for a large capacity of the engines, the compressed air system is mostly used for starting system. Battery driven motor can also be used for the starting of the diesel engine. And the engine can stop by stopping the fuel supply to the injection pump or stopping the actions of injection pump. Means how the engine is stopped? By stopping the fuel supply system, means by stopping this injection system, then the engine is stopped. Now the next system is the electric generators. Okay, so generator is connected with this diesel engine. So in diesel engine we supply the fuel, it's convert the mechanical energy. So this is the shaft of the diesel engine. So this is shaft is transport mechanical energy to these electrical generators. So function of the generator is convert the mechanical energy into a electrical energy. So here we discuss the few points of the generator. The function of generator or a alternator is to convert mechanical energy, means shaft power of the engines, into electrical energy. So what is the function of engine? Engine is convert chemical energy into mechanical energy. Mechanical energy means the shaft is rotated, it's called mechanical energy, and it is supplied to generator. Means in a generator, one shaft is there, shaft is rotated, and electric energy is produced. That is a different component is there, armatures and windings and that. Okay. The generator shaft is coupled with the engine shaft and are provided with automatic voltage regulators to allow the close voltage regulations and the satisfactory parallel operations. The alternator used in a diesel electric power plants are of rotating field, silent pole constructions. Speed is ranging from 214 to 1000 RPM, and the pole of the generator is 28 to 6. Capacity is ranging from 25 to 5000 kilowatt at 0.8 factor of lagging. Thank you for watching this video. If you like the video, then comment on the video, also like the video, and don't forget to share with your friend.